All right, this is the Logan Lathe. I've been getting a lot of questions about the collet closer and how it exactly works. So I'm just going to show you. So the chuck's off. This is a 2 1/4/8 thread, I believe, on the spindle. I just don't remember. So I have a spindle guard nut that I had made for this. So that just spins on there. That's just to protect your threads, basically. It would also, if I put a notch or holes in it, I could use it to get the adapter out. So now this has a taper. This is the 5C collet adapter that goes in. I have a little mark here on the spindle itself, and I align it with the keyway. That seems to be gives me basically almost zero run out on the collets. So that goes in there. Tap and make it tight. So that end's done, except for a collet. Now the collet will go in. There's a little pin to align on. There we go, and the collet's in, and then your workpiece will go in here. So we're just going to stick a scribe in there. Now we'll swing around the back side. So this is the back end of the spindle. Here's the spindle. Now this spindle does have it. Now there's some questions. This spindle does have a little taper here. Now that other nut, the original nut that I took off that came with the lathe, I don't think that was the right nut or the original at all. But it does have a little taper cut in here. But anyway, so this is where the change, this is obviously the change gear housing. Goes on there. We'll just leave it open. I had a question about the bar that stops it from rotating. It's just mounted right here. I think this is an original. It's original piece. It goes right in here, and it seems to be original. So our gear is just on here with a little Woodruff key. I took that off. There we go. So this is the nut I made. It goes on here. Now that's really no more than hand tight. It adjusts the tension on your bearings for as axial play goes. So it just needs to be really hand tight. I'm just going to leave this open so you can see this. Now this is the collet closer. We're just going to give you a run by there and thread it on the end for the collet to go in. And that just slips in here. So this just spins on the tube. This here is, this is the drive piece. It has a dog on it that we have a couple notches in here it slips into. And then there's these holes around the circumference. Okay, so people are wondering how this works. Well, okay, so this engages into the nut, which is attached to the spindle. So this supplies your drive power, this piece here. This part here with the cam, well, with the followers, let's call this the cam follower piece. This is attached with set screws to the tube, solid, right? This pin comes out, has a spring on it actually. You can see here it will snap in. This pin comes out and there's a little nice little notch that you turn it 180 and it locks in, locks out. This pin engages the drive piece. So when you screw, you turn this, and you're threading into the collet, and depending on your workpiece, if it's a thousandths over the size of the collet or a thousandths under the size, you have to adjust this so you get the right tension on your collet. So that's why there's so many holes. And once you find the right spot, you drop this into the hole and it will stay located in that position. But what it also does is all the power is transmitted through that little pin to the tube, so it spins at the same speed as the spindle, right? It locks it together, this little pin, and the friction, which I'll show you here. So these are spring-loaded, right here, these two followers, which I'm pulling on. They're fairly tight springs. But if you, we'll swing around here and show you in the back. As you pull on this, this part here presses against this here face. So now I'm going to pull on that, and you'll see how that comes out here in the back. Kind of hard to see, but this here edge presses against the plate when the dogs are opened. And that's what you're doing here on this cam. Is when it rides up the cam, it pushes the dogs out, and they press against this plate, but they push this piece here and the tube out. And that's what pulls. You're pushing against this, against solid, against the spindle, and you're pulling this out, and that's what pulls your collet tight. So we're going to put it in. We're going to thread the collet in. All right, so it's going to be somewhere in there, probably. Oh, I'm not going to be able to do this. All right, I'm going to back up here, and I'm going to close the door so I can get the arm here, which you can't see, so we can get this in the right spot to make this work right. So I'm going to pull this back out now and close the door, and then I'll come back with this back installed. All right, going back in with the door closed, and we're going to engage it, and then we're going to thread the collet on. All right, now we're going to swing our, here's our little arm right here I was talking about, and we're going to engage it in the end of the pivot arm. So now when I pull on this, it pushes those out, it cams out these, and presses against this plate, the drive plate here. It's like that. You can see how this pushes out. And that's what pulls your collet. It's not going tight right now. We need to tighten it up a little bit. Okay, now I'm getting a little bit, maybe one more. Oh, that feels pretty good. Then we take our pin and we get it locked into the hole, one of the holes, and feel how it, hard, easy, hard. And that gives me my tension on my workpiece. So this stays in, this is set, and it presses it out here, cams this out. Here's a close-up how that cams out. See that push? There you go. Cam out, locked. We're in the locked position. This nut that we made on the end is locked in position. You set that for the throw. How far does it need to go? Well, it needs to go until these ride up on the little flat area of the cam here. And actually, I could probably lengthen that out a little tiny bit. You want it to stay. If it's anywhere on that slope, it's just gonna fail on you and drop out. So that pulls and goes tight. The bearing is in here. That all this now is spinning together. It's locked together. This all spins. Nut, tube, cam. The cam followers or the cams plate and the drive plate all locked to the spindle. So between the little pin and the friction, that's what locks it to the spindle, the collet closer itself. But that's how it works. Pretty simple. You can just pull up on the handle, flip this out, let it drop. Some people will let them hang. If you get a lot of vibration, it's doing this. It will flip out by itself. That's what it was doing. It was that bad. That's how bad it was. But now we're in pretty good shape now. Now I'm getting a bunch of run out. See, this is my my dilemma. Sometimes I have zero. See, now it's almost zero. It's kind of weird. I don't know why, but yet this is why I still may make a whole new tube for it. But this is very usable the way it is right now, and I need to get my scribe project done, and then we'll go maybe readdress this and make the new tube. I have the material. But that's how it works. Now you can undo this and change your stock while it's running. Pull your piece out, put a new piece in, and re-engage. You don't need to turn your lathe off. That's one thing nice about this setup. Yeah, you just can undo it and then re-engage. And that's what a lot. That's how this one was probably used most of the time. There was a feed tube, a pneumatic feed tube that came in my lathe. I could put a full piece of stock in, and it always supplying pressure of stock through the tube. It always has pressure on it, so on your turret you have a stop for your stock. You have that selected. You release your collet and the stock gets pushed right out, automatically relock it, and you're ready to do it for your next part. But anyway, this is working pretty good really for now, and I'm probably going to have to readdress this a little bit more, making a new tube. So I hope everybody understands how this works. This collet closer is really very simple, the way this one works, and pretty foolproof. Of course, the one on my Lance lathe is a ball bearing one, locks to the spindle, runs concentric every single time you put it in. It's just perfect, very, very robust collet closer, and I really like that one. It just works so well. So, like I said, I have the guard off just so I can show you all this stuff. Then the guard goes back over, sits over this, so you can just access this and protects you from these dogs spinning around. All right, thanks, you guys. And thanks for, if you have any more questions, please write a comment. The little screws I'm working on, I'm going to, these are really 1032s. I might put in some M4 ball tip ones. I saw those in McMaster Car the other day, and a viewer also mentioned them. So I'm going to look into getting some of those and change these to an M4. I think I can get those in there. and they're ball tipped, they might work out really good. It's either that or going to be or a nylon or Teflon or something tipped one, something like that. But they got to be really short. So if I can get short enough ones, or I'm going to take these and I'm just going to grind them smooth and make them a little bit shorter, and so they're just right smooth on the shaft, because they have to slide. The tube has to slide. All right. Thanks again, you guys.